As we continue our monthly series on legacy landmarks in the region, our Molly Darrow takes us to the Oxford Memorial Library, which connects back to early history in the Shenango County town.
Welcome to the Oxford Library. Come on in.
Library Director Nancy Wilcox shows us inside the building with walls bearing stories as rich as the books it now holds.
Theodore Burr built the house about 1811. He actually came here in 1792, and in 1794 had built a grist mill right out here on the river.
The Shenango River, where a prosperous Burr built the Federal-style home, was also where he built Oxford's first bridge.
Burr was actually quite famous. He engineered, designed, and built covered bridges up and down the East Coast.
Around 1804, Burr first patented his arch truss bridge design,
which made the covered bridges quite a bit stronger.
Burr's passion for his arch design can be seen through various parts of this historic building.
Over the windows as we go through the building, especially on the ground floor.
Evidence of his arch design can still be seen, but Burr's own bridges have been lost over the years.
The library is the only remaining structure that was actually built by Theodore Burr.
Just as they've preserved elements of Burr's home, the library has preserved elements of his work.
What better place to have a resource center on covered bridges?
Burr only lived in the home about 2 years as he went to work elsewhere. The building's had several uses since.
It served as a rectory at one point, and then the Corbin family had it as a residence, and they are the ones that gave it to the town of Oxford, who in turn created the library.
Burr's own story came to an end in Pennsylvania in 1822.
Apparently, he was not one of the best business managers in the world, and ended up, sad to say, almost penniless when he did pass away.
But the tales of his successes live on in the Oxford Memorial Library. Reporting in Oxford, Molly Darrow, Fox 40, HG News.